Okay.
Scaffold for our class. Foot is boat shape. Foot is present in the scaffold for our. This is the characteristic feature of this class. These are commonly known as tusk shells or tooth shells. You can see the diagram here. This is the shell is present, dome-like, cone-like shell is present. That's why they are commonly known as tusk shells. Tusk is present in the elephant. Same, the shape is similar to that. Hence, it is known as tusk shells or tooth shells are common name of the scaphopods. These are mostly found in the marine water, but some are found in the fresh water also. Shell is tubular and tusk-like. Already we have discussed that it is tubular. Shell is present. Foot is cone-like and useful for digging. Here, this is the foot you can see here. And it is digs in the seashore. In the seashore, it digs the soil or sand and enters into burrows. It is useful for digging and also helps in the locomotion. And tentacles, eyes, gills, atria, all these are absent here. There is no distinct head is present and no eyes are present, no sensory organs, their tentacles are also absent and gills are also absent. But atria is also absent. All these organs are absent in this class. And instead of that, capitula, this is a thread-like structure. Small thread-like structures are arising from the body and which help in the food capturing. Here you can see these are the capitula, thread-like structures are arising from the body. They are useful for capturing the food material. And gills and atria are absent. Already we have discussed that also. Here gills and atria is also absent. And development includes larval forms. There are two types of larval forms are formed in the life history. One is the regular larva is present and the tropophore larva. These are the two larvas are present in the life history. As example is the deltalium and sodium. These are the two examples are considered in this class. These are the main characters of the scaphopoda, commonly known as the tusk shells.